Hello everyone, welcome to the Crash Course by me, Anuj Jindal. Today we are going to talk about new priority sector lending targets, and this is going to be very, very important for the upcoming RBI examination. So first of all, we are going to cover two things here. First of all, I'll have a look at the new priority sector lending targets, which have been revised recently. And secondly, and more importantly, I'm going to cover the entire priority sector lending guidelines, which is a 17-page document of RBI, and breaking it down is considered to be very, very difficult. I have broken it down for you. I'm going to teach the entire thing today itself, and then we will have a look at certain MCQs related to priority sector lending. So first of all, let's have a look at the new priority sector lending targets, and then we'll connect it with the entire priority sector lending guidelines of the RBI. The first one is sub-target of 8% of adjusted net bank credit, which is to be provided to small and marginal farmers, will now become applicable to foreign banks with 20 branches and above from financial year 2018-19. This is number one. Just remember these three guidelines, and then we'll go back and revisit the entire priority sector lending, and then we'll bring these three guidelines into that understanding. A sub-target of 7.5% of adjusted net bank credit on lending to micro enterprises, this is for small and marginal farmers, this is for micro enterprises, shall also become applicable to foreign banks with 20 or more branches. There is an applicable loan limit of 5 crore and 10 crore per borrower to micro or small and medium enterprises in services sector that now stands removed, that has been removed now. Shall qualify under priority sector without any credit cap. So there is no credit cap anymore. So let us take a blank sheet or blank screen, and let me break down the entire priority sector guidelines for you. Now, first of all, the latest ones were announced in the year 2015, and it was written in the 2015 document that they are to be revisited and revised in the year 2018. And therefore, the previous three revisions that I told you have been made. So this is number one that you need to understand or remember. Number two, there are certain areas where the priority sector lending is to be provided. We have already had a look at the changes which are required. So first of all, let's have a look at categories under priority sector categories. There are a total of 8 categories under priority sector. Number one is agriculture. Number two, we have micro, small and medium enterprises, MSMEs. Number three, we have export credit. Number four, we have education. Then we have housing. Then we have social infrastructure. The definition of social infrastructure and inclusions and exclusions are also provided. Then we have renewable energy sector, and then there is others, which includes weaker sections. So these are the 8 classifications that we have for categorization under priority sector lending. Now, what are the specifications under all of these, and what are the overall targets that have been given to banks? So let's draw a line here. Now, there are 3 classifications. Number one, scheduled commercial banks. Number two, foreign banks with more than or equal to 20 branches. And number three, foreign banks with less than 20 branches in India. Total priority sector lending target is 40% of adjusted net bank credit. We'll understand how adjusted net bank credit is to be found out. So this is 40% for scheduled commercial banks, and for foreign banks with more than or equal to 20 branches also it is 40%. They have to achieve this 40% target by March 2018. For foreign banks with less than 20 branches, the target is also 40%, but they do not have any sub targets. And it is to be achieved in a phased manner up to 2020. Now let me point it out. The target for 2018-19 is 38%, and target for 19-20 is 40%, because it is to be achieved in a phased manner. Now the first sub-target that we have here is agriculture. In agriculture, The sub target is 18% of adjusted net bank credit. Out of this 18%, 8% is to be provided to small and marginal farmers. So 8% to small and marginal farmers to be achieved by March 2017. This is now applicable to foreign banks also. 8% of the credit to small and marginal farmers. If we go back to the slide, we'll see here. Sub target of 8% to small and marginal farmers is applicable to foreign banks with 20 branches and above from financial year 2018-19. This is what I have mentioned here. So this is number one that has been changed. The second one that we have is for micro enterprises, not small and medium enterprises, only micro enterprises. The sub target is 7.5% of adjusted net bank credit, and now it is applicable to foreign branches, foreign banks with 20 or more branches in India. So if we go back, we will see here also sub target of 7.5% on lending to micro enterprises, now applicable to foreign banks with more than 20 branches. And the third one is weaker sections, which comes under others, advances to weaker sections. The sub target for scheduled commercial banks is 10% of adjusted net bank credit. The sub target of this 10% for foreign branches with foreign banks with more than or equal to 20 branches was to be achieved by 31st March 2018. So now it is also applicable to these foreign banks with more than or equal to 20 branches. I've already mentioned the targets which are to be met by the branches by the foreign banks with less than 20 branches. An additional 2% adjusted net bank credit is to be achieved post 2020. This has not been decided yet, so this will be decided later. Adjusted 2% of adjusted net bank credit post 2020 for lending to sectors other than exports. So this is not yet decided, so it's not very important as of now for our preparation. Now let us come to computation of adjusted net bank credit. And after that, we will have a look at all these subcategories one by one. And that is going to be very, very important. And we'll have a look at certain important questions also. So what exactly is adjusted net bank credit and how is it to be calculated? So the calculation for adjusted net bank credit is as follows. Number one, you have bank credit in India. That is the money that has been lent by banks to institutions or individuals. We reduce bills rediscounted with RBI, that is whatever credit has been provided by banks, if that has been redeemed, if that has been taken back by the banks. And then you arrive at net bank credit for banks. In this, you add one thing, that is bonds or debentures in non-SLR categories, because these bonds or debentures were the banks have invested or the banks have lent money is also an investment for the bank. So bonds or debentures in non-SLR categories, other investments eligible to be treated as priority sector, plus other outstanding deposits under RIDF. This is important. Outstanding deposits under RIDF also come under this, and other eligible funds, whatever funds the bank has with NABARD or NHB or SIDB, on account of priority sector shortfall plus outstanding priority sector lending certificates. So if the bank has outstanding priority sector lending certificates, all this when added together broadly gives us adjusted net bank credit. So this is something that you should be aware about very briefly. Now let's come to the specific areas. So we had 8 sub targets or 8 sub categories. And in these categories, we have already gone through the older and the new targets. Now let's come back to the categories. The first one is agriculture. It is applicable to number one, farm credit. Number two, agriculture infrastructure. If a farmer is creating agriculture infrastructure and if a bank is providing loan on that. And number three, ancillary activities. We'll also have a look at what exactly are ancillary activities. So in farm credit, you include not only farming of crops, but also dairy, fishery, animal husbandry, poultry, beekeeping, sericulture, all these kinds of activities, which are basically nothing but horticulture activities. So not only farming or crop activities, but also horticulture activities are included here. And the farm credit, there are certain targets as well as there are certain conditions here. Number one, loans to farmers up to 50 lakh against pledge or hypothecation of agriculture produce for a period not exceeding 12 months. Sorry. So if a farmer is provided loan up to rupees 50 lakh against hypothecation of agriculture produce or using agriculture produce as collateral, collateral is agriculture produce here, and the time period of this loan is less than equal to 12 months, then it can also be included under farm credit. Number two, loans to farmers under Kisan credit card scheme. So if a bank is providing loan to farmers under KCC scheme, that is also to be included under farm credit under agriculture sub targets that we have. Now let's come to agriculture infrastructure. If you are creating any storage facilities, that means warehouses, etc., have been created by a farmer, that money provided for creating that will also come under this. Soil conservation and watershed development activities. So if a farmer is involved in soil conservation infrastructure or watershed development infrastructure, that will also be included here. The aggregate sanction limit is 100 crore per borrower from the banking system. So what is the maximum amount of loan that you can provide? Rupees 100 crore per borrower. That is the maximum limit under this. The next one that we have is ancillary activities. Ancillary activities. Loans up to rupees 5 crore to cooperative societies of farmers for disposing of produce of members. So number one, cooperative societies up to rupees 5 crore. Outstanding deposits under RIDF and other eligible funds on account of priority sector shortfall. So whatever money goes to RIDF, to NABARD for Rural Infrastructure Development Fund, if a bank has shortfall in priority sector lending, that is going to be counted under ancillary activities under this. Now, what are the small and marginal farmers? Let's understand that also. We already know what are the limits that we have or the sub-targets that we have for small and marginal farmers. A marginal farmer is one who has a land holding of less than or equal to 1 hectare. So this also includes landless agricultural laborers, tenant farmers, and sharecroppers. These are also included in marginal farmers. And then you have small farmers, which includes people or farmers who have land holding of 1 hectare to 2 hectare. 1 to 2 hectare is considered as a small farmer. So this is all about agriculture. Now let's come to the second subcategory, which is micro, small, and medium enterprises. The thing to understand here is, first of all, the division is between manufacturing and services. Who is to be understood or classified as a micro, small, or medium enterprise? It is based upon investment in equipment or investment in plant and machinery. In the manufacturing sector, the classification is to be called a micro enterprise. The investment in plant and machinery should be less than equal to 25 lakh rupees. If you want to be categorized as a small enterprise, not a micro enterprise, then the investment should be between 25 lakh to 5 crore. And for a medium enterprise, the investment should be 5 crore to 10 crore. For the services sector, the investment in equipment, the limits are for micro enterprise, it is less than equal to 10 lakh. For small enterprise, it is 10 lakh to 2 crore. And for a medium enterprise, it is 2 crore to 5 crore. So these are the limits. Now, there were limits on how much can you lend to service enterprise if you want to be included, if a bank wants that loan to be included in priority sector lending. But now that limit has been removed, as I discussed in the previous slide. Let's go back to that. Okay, the first slide we said, remove the currently applicable loan limits of 5 crore and 10 crore per borrower to micro, small and medium enterprises in the services category. So there is no limit anymore. The limit has been removed. There was no limit in manufacturing before also, and the limit in services sector has also been removed. Now, Khadi and Village Industries sector, KVI sector, is also to be categorized as micro enterprises, and the SERP target is 7% or 7.5% for micro enterprises under priority sector. So that is very important. Khadi and Village Enterprises to be included or counted as micro enterprise. Let's come to the third one, which is export credit. Export credit, very, very important. For domestic banks, the target is 2% of adjusted net bank credit, subject to a sanction limit of 25 crore per borrower, and a turnover of this borrower should not be more than or should be less than 100 crore. So the borrowing limit is 25 crore, the turnover of the borrower should be less than 100 crore. For foreign banks also, it is 2% of adjusted net bank credit. No target on these lendings. For foreign banks with less than 20 branches, export credit is allowed 32% of adjusted net bank credit. So they can invest 32% of their total priority sector lending targets in export credit. This is very important. Let's come to the next one. The next one is education. In education, what are the targets? Number one, loans to individuals for educational purposes, including vocational courses, up to rupees 10 lakh. This is not the limit of loan. This is the limit of the value of the vocational course. The sanctioned amount does not matter here. The limit is 10 lakh. Anything less than or equal to 10 lakh will be taken into consideration. This is all that we have for education. Let's come to housing. In housing, in metropolitan sectors or metropolitan centers, 28 lakh is the limit, and in other areas, it is 20 lakh per family. The overall cost of the dwelling should not exceed 35 lakh here and should not exceed 25 lakh here. The purpose is to give it to only people who are going to buy small houses, basically affordable housing. There is also loan for repairs of damaged houses, and the limit is 5 lakh in metropolitan cities and 2 lakh in other centers. Come to the next category, which is social infrastructure. Social infrastructure. What are the targets here? Bank loans up to a limit of rupees 5 crore per borrower for building social infrastructure like school, like healthcare center, like water facilities, sanitation facilities in tier or tier 2 to tier 6 cities and not tier 1 cities. These are the only social infrastructure targets that we have. The next is renewable energy. Renewable energy like solar, wind or hydro energy. Loans up to rupees 15 crore per borrower for creating power generators, windmills, hydel plants, non-conventional energy plants, etc., etc. For individual households, the loan limit is 10 lakh per borrower. So these are for companies which are trying to build up these kind of infrastructure. If you are an individual and you want to install something like this in your household, then the limit is 10 lakh. Now, very interesting point, overdrafts extended by banks up to rupees 5,000 under Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana, provided the borrower's household income does not exceed 1 lakh for rural areas and 1,60,000 for non-rural areas, is going to be counted under others. So in others, we have weaker sections also. And if you are providing loan, if the bank is providing loan under Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana as an overdraft, the limit to which is rupees 5,000, and if it is provided to a person whose income does not exceed 1 lakh in rural and 1,60,000 in non-rural areas, then it is also going to be counted as priority sector lending. Now, the most important thing that we have to discuss is what are the categories under weaker sections? Who all are involved or included, in categories of weaker sections? So let's have a look at that. So the heading here would be weaker sections. Who all are to be included under weaker sections? Number one, small and marginal farmers. They are included under agriculture also and under weaker sections also. Artisans, village and cottage industries with individual credit limits less than equal to 1 lakh. They are included under weaker sections. Next is scheduled caste and scheduled tribes included under weaker sections. Self-help groups, so loans provided to self-help groups counted under weaker sections. Individual women beneficiaries, female beneficiaries, when the loan up to rupees 1 lakh is provided, is counted under weaker sections. Persons with disabilities also here, and overdrafts under Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana, as I said, under others category, it is going to be counted under weaker sections also. Up to rupees, overdraft up to rupees 5000. And minority communities, which are now and then from time to time classified by the government of India. So any minority community, if a loan is provided to that, that also will be counted under weaker sections and counted under priority sector lending targets. Let's have a question on this. Which of the following is not one of the amendments made in priority sector lending targets recently? The options are sub-target of 8% of adjusted net bank credit for foreign banks with 20 or more branches for lending to small and marginal farmers. This is one of the amendments. Remove the current applicable limit of 5 crore and 10 crore for services. Yes. Sub-target of 7% to micro enterprises above branches in India for foreign banks. Yes, it is also there. Sub-target of 10% for lending to medium enterprises for foreign banks with 20 and above branches. This is not one of the amendments. Only three amendments have been made recently. So here I have covered the entire priority sector lending in detail and also the amendments that have been made recently. If you like this lecture, please subscribe to my YouTube channel now. You can also provide me feedback on the comment section below, and I will make sure that those feedbacks are implemented to the best possible manner. You can also join my YouTube community where I post quizzes on a regular basis. I post quizzes on a regular basis and also provide notifications about the upcoming videos. You can also join my Facebook and Telegram groups, which are named as Success RBI 2018. The links to these are available in the description section below. So you can join these groups and take advantage of the quizzes that I post here regularly. You can also join the mobile app that I have, which is called as Infinity. It's an Android Google app available on Google Play Store. And you can take advantage of all the quizzes that I have held till now, as well as free phase 1 and phase 2 material, which has been posted here. You can download.